Hello. So let's move on to the main line. e4 c6, d4 d5, knight c3 d, knight f4, bishop f5, knight g3, bishop g6, h4 h6, knight f3 e6, knight f5, bishop h7, bishop d3, bishop d3, queen d3, knight d7, and f4. And my recommendation is the move bishop b7. It's very fresh idea. The first game from this line was played in 2016, and of course black played takes this in other days, but the idea is not bishop b7, but then to give up two pawns on g7 and h6. We will see that in a moment, but let's try another moves for white. So the main move is bishop d2, just to develop quickly. It's Nagy's choice in his book, but he finishes analysis too soon. And in the Halfman's book, you will see the finish of the analysis also very soon. So let's try other moves. h5. Well, I don't believe in this move. Knight gf6. If bishop d2, then queen c7, and it's another line of playing. So white should play bishop e3 first, but we play queen a5, bishop d2, and queen c7, and we just transpose in the position by force. Castle's long, and the novelty is rook d8. So our idea is to play c5 very quickly. For example, queen f3 c5, knight d7, rook d7, dc, and castles. Of course, it's too dangerous for white to play before now. Well, maybe you can analyze this position in some more details, but I really think that white has no attacking chances. Black just played c5 very easily and very quickly. So another move is a tricky one. It's knight h5, and black should play knight gf6. White cannot play knight f6, because after knight f3 f5, black has better position. Look at all these holes on g4 and on f4 and so on. So white should take on g7, but it's a sacrifice after king f8, knight e6, f takes e6. So white sacrifices a piece, and this position is an interesting choice. I don't think that knight g6 is critical, because black plays king g7, and if now h5, then just rook g8, protecting the rook. Now g4, black even can take on g4 and play knight df6. So bishop d2, but then knight f8, and if castle, then just knight g6, hg, and queen d5. The idea of playing queen f5 changes the queen, so black is just piece up. Maybe knight e5, but then black plays queen d5, castles long, queen 2c3, king h8, and engine says that it's a repetition of moves. Well, in the practical game, everything just starts at the position. So knight h8, and now it's very important moment that black should exchange queens. So queen a5 is a critical idea. Bishop d2 and queen f5. Now castles, and queen d3, cd, and rook takes h8. And if rook h3, then you can start with queen d3, with rook h8, then queen d3. That was game between two engines. So I think the position is more or less equal, but easier to play with black, because in the 10 game, black has too many pieces. I think that critical move is bishop d2. And now black should play rook h7. And the best move for white is rook h3. g4, it's not a good idea, because king g8, rook g1, and just exchange on e5, f takes e5 at knight e8. Harameyan against Torizaga, black was better. Also, castles on just king g8, king b1, h5, rook h1, rook g7, knight g6, knight f8. The game between two engines, I think that black is perfectly fine. So rook h3, That was point by Garen Master Gavin Jones. Rook g7, and what's the difference? F5 now comes, and rook protects the queen. So after knight e5, d, queen d3, and rook d3. And black has some problems to solve, but we have modern engines, and after rook g2, e takes f6, we can play better move than the opponent of Gavin Jones did. It's just winning an exchange by rook g1, king e2, rook a1, bishop h6, king e7, f takes a7. And I think that his opponent stopped calculating this way at that moment because it looks scary, but what plays rook e8, and it's just 0.0 now. If now f6, we take on a2, rook b3, king f6, bishop g5, king f7, rook b7, a5, and I think it's just an equal position. And if bishop g5, that's the choice of the engine, rook a2, fe, king e6, rook e3, king f7, it's just a draw by perpetual check. So, an interesting line to play for both sides and to analyze it further. Maybe we will see new ideas in that knight h5 move. But the main move is bishop d2, knight e5, f takes e5, and bishop h4, and white castles. If white plays c3, we will transpose to our one of next videos of the taking on g3 play, knight e7, queen g7, rook g8, queen h6, queen d5, castles, and to directly transpose, we play queen a2, bishop g5, and it's a transposition. See you in one of the next videos with this position. So castles short, castles long, it's the universal answer. And bishop g3, queen g3, and a novelty, knight e7, one of the best moves I think of 2016, a new idea. And of course white's main move is to take queen g7, but let's try other moves. So white can play rook f1, and black's idea in such position is just to play queen d5 and to castle long. So queen g7, castle long, queen f7, knight f5, and black has no problems. We will see similar position in the next videos, but it's a good reduction for black. Rook df1, we also play queen d5, queen g7, and castle long. And if bishop g5, trying to use the pin, rook dg8, queen f7, knight f5, bishop h6, then the easiest move for black is knight g3, bishop g7, and winning the piece. Knight h1, bishop h8, rook h8, queen g7, queen d8, rook f7, and knight f2. White cannot take the knight because rook h1 check. So c3, knight f4, rook b7, rook g8, and white should do the perpetual check. Well, it's not a forced line, but it's the easiest line for black. And white can try to attack the knight with two moves. The first one is bishop b4. I don't like that move. Knight f5, queen f4, and black should know the move g5, and black is already better. So if queen f3, well, the idea of this move is to protect against g4, but then easy play for black. Queen d5, queen d5, cd g4, Nielsen against Rasmus, and here black should have played knight g3, rook h3, knight e4, rook d h1, and the critical move is f5. Of course, it's bad for white to take on h6 because in the 10 game black pawns are too strong. So it takes f6, but then king f7, rook h6, rook h6, rook h6, knight f6, bishop d2, rook g8, and white has some problems in the 10 game with defending g4 pawn. So queen f2 was played in the game, g4, and VE against Giri tried c4, but it's already a big mistake. Better was to play rook d3, but black plays queen d5 anyway, b3 and castles long, and black is just pawn up. And after c4, a5, Bishop c5, b6, bishop a3, queen g5, king b1. Best move black was queen e3, just exchanging the queens, and black is close to winning. So maybe slightly better move is bishop g5 with some similar ideas. Black plays knight f5, queen f4, and queen d7. G4 and knight f7. The idea of playing queen d7 is that now white goes rook f1, we just play knight d5, knight g6. In the game, white tried bishop e7, queen f7, rook h5, castles alone, c3 and c5, and black was better and won the game. Bromberger against Rucker. The engine thinks that queen f2 is slightly better. If now castles, that is the move, but d5, and the game becomes very double-edged, so I think that black should play rook f8 instead, bishop d2 and castle. So d5, cd, queen a7, knight c6 is just pawn up for black, so bishop b4, b6, queen h4 and f6, and black wants to play rook f7 next, and white has, of course, some compensation for the sacrifice pawn. The position is more or less equal, but the pawn is a pawn. So let's make some conclusions about this line. We saw very interesting move, knight h5. Maybe we will see some more exciting games in that direction in the nearest future. But the main line is to play bishop d2, where we reach this position by force, and we do very good move knight e7, and we saw that white really should take one g7, because white could be in a trouble if white doesn't take this pawn. So in the next videos I'll talk about queen takes g7. See you again soon. Goodbye.